Now, they often say that too much of a good thing is often bad, but what if we applied that same idiom to the most essential component of our ensured human survival? Oxygen, the breath of life, sweet, sweet, fresh air, the best friend to our lungs, our blood, and our brains, and the only reason that we can continue watching this video for the next 9 or so minutes. Oxygen is awesome, and it's safe to say that without it, we wouldn't ever be around to posit ourselves upon this particular hypothetical notion. Now, although we've covered the Earth's supply of oxygen cutting out in various experimental LBs, today, let's see what life would be like with more of the stuff. And believe me, things would be much more interesting than you might first have expected. Hello, Internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if the oxygen on Earth doubled? Roll the clip.
Then shock, convulsions, acidosis.
Is it gonna hurt?
Yeah.
For the curious amongst you, that clip was from the 2000 sci-fi film Red Planet, starring Val Kilmer and Simon Baker, and although that scene in particular was perhaps the complete opposite as to the implications of this Life's Biggest Question, for those of you that have already seen the final events of Red Planet, you'll know that putting oxygen in places that it doesn't belong, more often than not, is a pretty bad thing. But let's forget all about Mars in this particular situation, and instead focus on our own lovable pale blue dot of a planet. Earth. And to first address this hypothetical question, we can actually turn our minds to the long forgotten places of ancient history to get a better handle on how things would play out if the oxygen on Earth doubled. Interestingly enough, through all manners of geology, we can turn the clock back to a time where the abundance of life-giving air was, in fact, exactly that. Double. Well, nearly anyway. Over 300 million years ago, Earth's atmosphere was around 31-35% oxygen, nearly a third more than what it is now, and the effects that it had on the flora and fauna that populated our planet at the time was staggering. As we mentioned previously, oxygen is the most important element to us humans, and as far as life is concerned, it is the fundamental building block for life to create energy and vice versa. So then you could easily imagine that with twice the amount of oxygen would come twice the amount of life, or in this case, twice the size of life. Yeah, stick with me. During prehistoric times, in an age where gigantic lizards roamed the Earth, even insects were more than twice the size of what they are now. Over eons, as these creatures breathed the densely oxidized environment filtering through their trachea and the spiracles which connect their tissues that need oxygen, the enriched source of atmosphere caused their bodies to expand and rapidly kickstart their evolutionary growth rate. In most cases, dragonflies were the size of hawks, and even smaller species of spiders were the size of large pigeons. There was even a 6-foot centipede roaming around in North America and Scotland. That's pretty terrifying, right? In fact, if the oxygen on Earth doubled right this second to the levels that they were at during the Pennsylvanian period of the Paleozoic era, the effects that it would have on the human body would be immediately staggering compared to the hundreds of thousands of years that these giant insects had to adapt and thrive. If we stepped outside and breathed in the fresh air of an oxygen doubled environment, we'd more than likely be hit with such an immediate head rush that we'd straight up pass out. Our brains would be drunk off of the dizzying potency of the air itself, and we'd very quickly understand just exactly how delicate our current ecosystem is. However, once we'd adapted to this oxygen-doubled environment, we'd potentially be able to reap a wide variety of anatomical benefits. Due to the brand new abundance and availability of oxygen to your lungs, with every breath you take and every move you make, your physical stamina would increase tremendously. In this new environment, the blood that pumps through your veins would become so oxygen rich and your muscles so energized that even an averagely healthy human would be able to perform on par with the most capable of professional athletes. Students across the globe would rejoice as the improved circulation of the human body made drastic changes in the effectiveness of human concentration, and even the most astonishing of human minds currently thinking would be inundated with eureka after eureka as their brain gobbled up more oxygen. This newfound productivity for the human race would be incredibly short-lived, and it may quickly seem that too much of a good thing is indeed, in this case, a very bad thing. Because in reality, although in the short term our bodies would reap the benefit of double the Earth's oxygen, in the long run, it would also slash our lifespan pretty much in half. You see, oxygen is a free radical, and in the scientific world, that pretty much means that it does what it wants at a cellular level, often resulting in the detriment of a system. In many ways, ways, oxygen is a double-edged sword. For all its positives, it's also a toxic element. In this case, more oxygen would mean more oxidative stress on our metabolism, which would lead to rapid cellular damage and could even cause adverse effects on our central nervous system. We'd age faster, the cellular structure of our skin would diminish quicker, and all in all, we'd live much shorter lives than what we do now if the oxygen on Earth doubled. And if that didn't hammer home the duplicitous nature of an oxygen-abundant environment, then we'd also need to address the fact that things tend to catch fire the more the oxygen is present. Yeah. Now, although this isn't one of those instant global firestorm type of situations, it could, in fact, very quickly and very easily lead to one. Again, if we look back at prehistory, where the atmosphere was nearly 35% oxygen, the Paleozoic landscape was littered by continent-wide wildfires, thanks to the oxygen density having a habit of spurring on even the smallest of combustions. If you lit a campfire on our hypothetical Earth in the middle of a dry forest, it would instantly ignite everything. With the presence of more oxygen as fuel, continental wildfires would become the norm, and humanity better hope that the increased physical capabilities bestowed upon them were put to good use in order to ensure our survival. On the upside though, mountainous regions such as the Himalayas would quickly become much more human-friendly environments, so if the worst came to worst, we could always seek refuge under the shadow of Mount Everest, where the atmospheric pressure would be much easier for us to stomach. Or breathe, I guess. If all of this has got you a little worried at the prospect of the Earth suddenly bursting with an abundance of more oxygen, then please don't panic, because thankfully for us, our wonderful planet called Earth has spent millennia cultivating the delicately crafted atmosphere to ensure that we're all comfortable and relatively healthy humans that can happily contribute to our planet's continued success in a perfectly balanced 21% oxygen environment. It took a while to get there, but hey, at least 6-foot centipedes aren't a thing anymore, right? Right? Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if the oxygen on Earth doubled? We'd live much shorter lives, the planet would be a regular blazing hellfire, insects would grow bigger, and we'd probably have to live in the mountains. But hey, we could run pretty fast. Well, what did you guys think? Do you agree, disagree, have any more interesting insights to add? Then please let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any choice picks of your own. Before we depart from today's video, if you'd like to continue on with your questioning binge, then please make sure to click our relevant playlist floating conveniently at the side. Unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video or just Life's Biggest Questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and please, until next time, you take it easy.